The Kaupai Plant Conservatory is a collection of greenhouses that showcases different environments in our goal of supporting the biological sciences department, as well as getting people stoked on plants.
It's a glasshouse complex with a bunch of different growth chambers and areas in which we grow specific plants from different habitats. The first house you encounter as you come in is what's called the lowland tropical house. Imagine the Amazon basin, where you have real high humidity, high temperatures, lots of water, a typical tropical forest. And there is the tallest glasshouse, so we have big tropical trees in there.
Most of those plants, they're light limited. They're in the shade of this huge forest. And so they have all these cool adaptations, like the undersides of their leaves are purple, or their leaves are massive, or they climb other trees to try to get up to the sunlight. And so you'll feel that warm, dense, sort of humid environment of the lowland tropics.
The next is the cloud forest, which is like if you wandered onto a misty mountaintop in the tropics, a lot of orchids and carnivorous plants.
These are plants that are not water limited at all. They tend to grow on top of other plants. They don't even have roots, some of them. These are all of our cool epiphytes. They hang and drape off of other plants. They're these little orchids that live out on the branches of trees and never put their roots into the ground. And so you have a lot of canopy species.
There are places in the world that never freeze, their temperatures never get low, but they're high elevation. The humidity is very high, but the temperature is a little lower. And there's all these really interesting cloud forest plants that grow in that glasshouse.
Then we have the desert room, which mimics the arid regions of the world. Those plants are incredibly water limited. They have a lot of sunlight, and so they've evolved these very unique forms to deal with not having water. So most of them are succulent plants where they store the water in their tissues. So they're big round cacti or they're tall columnar euphorbias. And so you get to see sort of every variation of how a plant could hack it in a very dry environment.
We're mimicking deserts from really interesting places throughout the world, from the northern portions of Africa to South Africa to the deserts of South America. Things that we don't have here, and so really cool cacti and succulents that you don't get to see growing outside in California.
Sometimes I'll be sitting in the courtyard and you just like ever so slightly from across the facility hear, whoa, as they walk into the greenhouse, and it's wonderful.
I love to see the student reactions when they walk into the lowland tropical houses. Oh, look at this. And sometimes they're getting rained on and they're having a very different actual physical experience. And it's something you don't forget the first time you walk into a place like that.
This is a student-run facility. Things that students get excited about, that's what's growing here. Plants that are growing well, it's because a student is tending them. And so this is actually a place where you get hands-on experience making this facility what you want. And so it is a student facility at its core, and there's not many other places that have a facility like that.
Spaces like this that are dedicated towards research projects at Cal Poly are important because they allow students the access to be able to have the space and the equipment and the environment that they need to ask and answer certain questions. And this space allows for that to happen.
Another huge role that this conservatory plays is that it exposes students to plants that are rare and endangered in the environment. Who's going to protect these species? Who's going to care about conservation if you don't have any relationship to that organism at all? And so students can come here to the conservatory, they learn these plants, they learn their names, they learn where they're from, they learn about the threats to those plants in their native ecosystems, and then hopefully we're cultivating a generation of conservation biologists who are interested in protecting these plants.
This facility is a College of Science and Math facility, but the students that come here range from everything from an English major to an engineering major, and they work with plants, and they're united by their love of plants and their love of growing things and seeing things change in the plant world. So ultimately, this facility is for our students, and that's why we built it. That's why we built the program, is so students could have a learn by doing experience with the plants that are around them.